Hi folks, Jake von Slatt here, and what I'm going to show you today is how to take a regular bus window that works like this, that opens from the top, and turn it into one that works like this, that opens from the bottom like a conventional household window. And as an added benefit, when you swap the fixed pane and the movable pane, you can then cut down a conventional storm window screen to fit in the track and snap right in. So let's get to it. Thank you. first thing I'm going to do is disassemble the window frame and swap the components of the moving piece left for right. Set the fixed pane aside. Okay, so this was originally on the outside and moved in this direction. You remember they slid down from the top. We want it to be on the inside, and we want it to go up like a regular window. So we want this weather stripping on the other side, these on this side, but we want them switched left for right so that this angle is on top. So I'm going to do that by taking apart the bottom of the window. And this is held together with four more Torx screws. Okay, and now I can just spread this and take off the bottom piece. Okay, now. The window glass has a little sandblasted emblem on it, so if you care about the position of that, what you'll want to do at this time is take the glass out. Flip the frame so the weather stripping's on the outside, and then glass so the logo is on the inside in the lower right hand corner. And then you can slide that back in to the frame. Okay, now we need to switch these left to right. And the way these come out is once you remove these little springs, you can slide this plastic bit up and all the way out. Sometimes you've got to tap this a little bit. and then the plastic bit slides up and out, and you can remove that bit. Okay, now we want to switch these two parts around, and I like to put a little grease in the channel. Sometimes aluminum can bind a little bit. Okay, so they simply slide back in. Engage the plastic bit, slide that in, and reinsert the springs. And we're all set on that side. Same procedure here. Plastic goes in, engages, slide the springs in. Okay. Now we can reinstall this in the bottom of the moving window frame. It is a little chewy. Get a fresh one. And that's all we need to do to the bottom frame. So let's set that aside. Now the first thing I'm going to do with these bits is take off the caulking. Okay, and because we're turning the window around, the sill is angled, so I need to cut this flat, and I'll do that on the table saw. Because the sill is angled, I have to cut the bottom of each window flat, since we are switching the sides left for right, and I'll do that here on the table saw. Okay, so now I'm going to take care of the top pane. First thing I'm going to do is put the frame back together again, now that I've cleaned off all of the bits of caulking and stuff. Okay, so now looking at the frame, the larger channel is the moving panel. We want that on the inside. The fixed panel goes in the skinnier channel. So this is the fixed panel, and I'm basically going to keep it oriented in the same way. And the top and bottom of the fixed panel, these pieces are identical. This one has some paint from the outside of the bus on it, so I'm going to keep that outside. And then the logo here is going to go inside on the bottom. So this will slide in here. Because this will butt up against this, I'm going to put a bead of silicone on it before I assemble it. I'm going to loosen this screw a little bit. Okay. Take that up. All right, now we'll slide the fixed window pane in. And this bottom piece will go in here, but the holes don't line up. They're configured for this bar to be in this orientation. So I need to drill a second pair of 3/16 inch holes, half an inch offset from the current pair. the thick Indian case. There is mixed pane order.
Then I'll put some trunk glue in here. Like I said, yeah, so I'll come there. Take care of that bolt. Here, this.
Okay, now what we need to do is we need to cut some slots to hold the latch with the bottom of the window to lock it, and then drill some holes so we have a few positions and for the window to slide up and lock into. In order for the window to lock, there has to be a slot at the bottom of the frame for the shoulder of the latch to engage when the window's all the way down. So it has to hit on this flat part here. And sometimes you can file that, make that a little bit bigger if it doesn't quite fit. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to break out this tab, and then I'm going to use a file to extend that slot to exactly 1 inch, because that's the dimension of the top of those latches. Bottom slot is 1 inch up exactly. little bit off center, so I'm squaring it off a bit. Okay. Now the final hole. It's drilled 12¾ inches up the channel. Need something longer than 12 inches. I want to try to clean up any burrs in here. Because that is the channel that it slides in. Slip it, moving. Okay, now we can pin in pane. And we can sit the box, see, and then it locks at the place and go three different. You have it. Hang on. And there you go.